Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzong. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 5th of May. India post record daily rise in coronavirus deaths as cases top 20 million. US envoy Khalilzad says strong international consensus against Taliban military takeover. And coronavirus wave forces Nepal to cremate bodies out in open. And now for all the details. India on Wednesday registered 382,350 new COVID-19 cases and deaths rose by a record 3,780 during the last 24 hours. Maximum casualties were reported in Western Maharashtra state, which alone contributed for 13.57% of the new infection cases across India. India's coronavirus deaths rose by a record 3,780 during the last 24 hours, the highest in a day so far, pushing the total fatalities to 226,188. This comes a day after the country became the world's second after the United States to cross the grim milestone of 20 million infections. Amid the rising cases in Indian capital New Delhi, which is facing the acute shortage of medical oxygen, two huge medical plants were installed at one of its largest hospitals.
ये 1000 लीटर पर मिनट ऑक्सीजन जनरेट करता है तो ये और इसका आप जैसा आपको पता है कंटिन्यूस ऑपरेट करता रहेगा तो अब जितने भी हमारे जो हॉस्पिटल है जहां जाए सेटअप रहेगा उन्हें अब सप्लाई पे डिपेंड नहीं रहना पड़ेगा उनके कैंपस में एक ऑक्सीजन प्लांट लगेगा और वो डायरेक्टली अपना मतलब इस ऑक्सीजन प्लांट से पेशेंट को ऑक्सीजन सप्लाई कर सकते हैं.
Meanwhile, at the time when Indian government is being criticized over mishandling its coronavirus crisis and allowing crowded religious and political events, Indian Foreign Minister S. J. Shankar, in an exclusive interview to ANI News Agency, said, India is a democratic country and it do not stop elections. On receiving assistance from foreign countries to fight COVID-19, Jaishankar argued that India had also sent medical supplies to other nations, describing such assistance as friendship as support instead of aid.
We gave medicines, hydroxychloroquine, paracetamol, we gave to the United States, okay? We gave to Singapore, we gave to European countries. We sent a medical team to Kuwait. We gave actually vaccines to some countries in the Gulf. Now, would you have described it as aid? We described it actually as friendship. As support.
Over the past few years, India had been refusing any kind of aid from foreign countries, focusing on self-reliance, but has recently opened up to receiving aid as it faces a dire shortage of medical supplies and oxygen. Trinamool Congress Chief Mamata Banerjee took oath as the Chief Minister of Eastern West Bengal State for the third consecutive term on Wednesday. She was administered the oath by Governor Jagdeep Dhankar. Trinamool Congress secured 213 seats in the 8-phase assembly elections, while Prime Minister Narendra Modi's Bharatiya Janata Party won 77 seats. Since the election verdict on Sunday, there have been clashes in parts of Bengal involving both the Trinamool Congress and the BJP. Both parties have traded blame for the violence. Hours after Banerjee's oath of office, BJP National President J.P. Nadda on Wednesday said, "We also take an oath that we will dismantle political violence in the state." Nadda is on two-day visit to West Bengal starting from Tuesday to hold a protest against the alleged atrocities on party workers in the state by the ruling Trinamool Congress government. Moving on. Amid the surge in coronavirus cases in Pakistan, smart lockdown has been imposed in four towns of its financial capital, Karachi, till May 18. Expressing concerns over rising cases in Karachi, Pakistan Information Minister Fawad Chaudhry said that there is a need for precaution in Karachi and warned that if coronavirus SOPs were not implemented properly in the metropolis, the effect on the rest of the country would be felt very fast.
Karachi, the financial capital of Pakistan, has imposed a smart lockdown in four of its towns till May 18 in a bid to curtail the spike in coronavirus cases. Karachi administration on Tuesday issued a notification in this regard, announcing that multiple areas of Gulberg, Liaquatabad, North Karachi and North Nazimabad will be under lockdown, local media reported. Expressing concerns over rising cases in Karachi, Pakistan Information Minister Fawad Chaudhry said that there is a need for precaution in Karachi and warned that if coronavirus standard operating procedures were not implemented properly in the metropolis, the effect on the rest of the country would be felt very fast. According to Pakistan's Health Ministry data, 4,113 people were tested positive in the last 24 hours on Wednesday, while 119 people lost their lives, with most fatalities being reported in Punjab. This comes as in a positive sign, the number of registrations for the coronavirus vaccine in Pakistan have been increasing significantly, as over 200,000 people got vaccinated against the virus on Tuesday.
In news from Afghanistan, the U.S. Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad has said that the Taliban plan to seize control of Afghanistan with a military takeover would not be acceptable to the world. Khalilzad emphasized that there was strong consensus within both the regional and international community against any effort by the Taliban to pursue a military takeover.
The U.S. Special Representative for Afghanistan Reconciliation, Zalmay Khalilzad, has said that a Taliban plan to seize control of Afghanistan with a military takeover would not be acceptable to the world. According to a statement from the U.S. Embassy, Khalilzad emphasized that there was strong consensus within the both regional and international community against any effort by the Taliban to pursue a military takeover. Only a negotiated settlement can end over 40 years of war in Afghanistan, and Ambassador Khalilzad pledged common cause with Afghan leaders to accelerate efforts to reach an inclusive settlement and permanent and comprehensive ceasefire. In a separate meeting with Afghan political leaders in Kabul, Khalilzad called for a political consensus to be formed among Afghan political leaders to help pave the way for successful peace negotiation talks with the Taliban. Meanwhile, President Ashraf Ghani has said that with the completion of the withdrawal of foreign forces, all decisions regarding the country will be taken by the Afghan people and the government. He again called on the Taliban to surrender to peace.
As cremation space at temples and crematoriums have run out amid raging coronavirus cases, residents in Nepal's capital of Kathmandu have been forced to cremate bodies of COVID-19 victims out in the open. The Himalayan nation is now bearing the brunt of the second wave of infection, which is expected to peak in June.
In Nepal, the bodies of those succumbing to COVID-19 are being cremated on the banks of the Bagmati River that runs through the Kathmandu Valley, as the cremation space at temples and crematoriums have run out amid raging coronavirus cases. The Pashupati Area Development Trust from Monday started cremating bodies of COVID-19 victims in open grounds, as one of the two electric crematoria requires repairing and maintenance. Nepal, like India too, has been seeing an exponential surge in the number of cases. The daily count of new infections on Tuesday hit a record high of 7,660. The country has been reporting deaths in double digits for the past few days.
विगत केही दिन देखि अलिकति संख्या बढेको हुनाले गर्दा हामीले भित्र धेरै समय नराखिकन सिधै क्रिमेसन गर्ने प्रोसेसमा गयौं त्यसैले गर्दा लामो समय नराखौं भनेर हामीले बाहिर पनि व्यवस्था गरेका छौं र अहिले दैनिक चाहिँ औसतमा 20 देखि 25 वटा सबहरु चाहिँ
owing to the increasing number of coronavirus cases, the local administration of Kathmandu Valley has extended the prohibitory orders by another week. The prohibitory order that was imposed since April 29 would now remain in place until midnight of May 12.
Moving on, Sri Lanka is facing a shortage of 600,000 doses of the Oxford AstraZeneca Covishield vaccine to complete the second round of the vaccine program. State Minister of Primary Healthcare Epidemics and COVID Disease Control Dr. Sudarshini Fernandopoulou during the debate on the situation the country is facing in the face of COVID risk in the parliament cited the shortage due to delay in delivery of vaccines from manufacturer India. Dr. Sudarshini Fernandopoulou, State Minister of Primary, Healthcare, Epidemics and COVID Disease Control on Tuesday, acknowledged in the Parliament that Sri Lanka is facing a shortage of 600,000 doses of Oxford AstraZeneca COVID-19 vaccine. Under the first round, 925,242 persons were vaccinated and at present, Sri Lankan Health Ministry has about 350,000 doses. And as a result, there is a shortage of 600,000 doses because of the delay in getting them from India. Sri Lanka is also looking towards the research that is taking place about a cocktail vaccine for the second dose to those who already received the vaccine. Sudarshini said, adding a decision will only be made on the matter based on global research and approval. Meanwhile, the Indian Ocean Island nation received its first batch of the Russia Sputnik V vaccine on Tuesday. The number of COVID patients is rapidly rising across the country over the last week. Sri Lanka's total number of positive cases have reached 111,753 with 696 fatalities. The first drive-in vaccination center in India's financial capital, Mumbai, opened on Tuesday and was received with a positive response. Senior citizens and specially able citizens can get their vaccine doses while sitting inside the car at this facility.
Authorities in India's financial capital, Mumbai, one of the hardest hit by the COVID-19 pandemic, have started operating the country's first drive-in vaccination facility in a bid to ramp up the immunization drive. Senior citizens and specially able citizens can get their vaccine doses while sitting inside the car at this facility. Beneficiaries will have to spend 30 minutes inside the vehicle for the vaccination process.
If you have aged patients at home, tumko tumhara gaadi ka safety bhi rehta hai, convenience bhi rehta hai, plus gaadiyon ke beech mein distance ka social distancing bhi ho jata hai. Because dusri jagah jaake line mein khade rahoge to fir apne uta hi risk rehta hai infection ka, cross contamination ka. So this is much better option.
Bahut acha experience hai. Main chal nahi sakta, mujhe problem hai. 74 year old aur mera beta hai Dr. Saad and my this thing is there, she is chartered accountant in this big company, they have brought me here aur bahut acha experience hai, bahut acha hai gaadi mein baith ke ye karke lena hamare jaise logon ke liye.
India, with the world's biggest vaccine making capacity, has partially or fully immunized only 9.5% of its 1.35 billion people according to the government's COVID portal. Meanwhile, the number of daily COVID-19 infections in Maharashtra state has significantly come down in the last few days, as from around 70,000 daily cases, the state is recording around 50,000 new cases.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. India posts record daily rise in coronavirus deaths as cases top 20 million. U.S. Envoy Khalilzad says strong international consensus against Taliban military takeover. And coronavirus wave forces Nepal to cremate bodies out in open. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.